Hello.
Nice. Hey, good to see you. Merry Christmas.
Nice to see you too.
Nice to
see you too.
I think the feeling is still the feeling is always the same whether you visit this home once or whether you visit it twice, and we have been my team has been and myself have been a regular visitor to this home, and it's always this sadness that engulfs you to know that there are people who have been neglected by their families, and especially when they are at this age where they are supposed to be given care, love and respect within their homes. So actually it's very sad, and like I mentioned, what's more shocking is the fact that when one of the residents passes away, it's the family who comes forward to perform the final rites. And I think from next year we'll try to work on that and to see how best we can reunite these citizens with their families rather than allowing a situation to come where we may have to, you know, put our foot down and say, look, let us perform the final rites because they have been in our care. So I hope it doesn't come to that. And of course, the other things that is of concern to us is the fact that at this age they need the love from their families, which they don't get. And so that's another reason why we sort of become very emotional. And the advice that we want to give to our elders in the home is for them to bond with those that are around there and share their joys and sorrows. And the plans are to keep them more active, you know, keep them engaged in activities which will allow them to forget the separation. And a lot of them actually have a desire to see their families. And one such case was when the team visited Samambula. And I think the PS and the team contacted the children and the grandchildren, and this senior citizen is now going to spend Christmas with them. But that's not the whole point. It's not only during celebrations that they want to spend time. They want to spend time with their families while they are alive. And for a society, for a small country like Fiji, and for such a close-knitted society that we have, the close-knitted Fijian society that we have, it's indeed sad to see that prevalence of elderly care in the homes is increasing. Eh? And I think to date we have about 44 senior citizens here, and we have the same number in Babasinga and a higher number in Samambula. So that becomes a challenge for us, and that's why from next year we will base a welfare officer, a full-time welfare officer would be based in all our three homes, so that we can be informed of the issues that the home faces. And the other plans is to ensure that we increase the level of comfort within the homes, whether it's caregiving, whether it's diet, whether it's recreation. we will look into that. And at the same time, if I may thank the public, yeah, I've been told that the public has been very generous in the provisions for some of the things for the senior citizens. But all in all, if I may also remind the public that this should not be used as a dumping ground. Definitely, this should not be used as a dumping ground for second-hand clothes, second-hand beddings, second-hand stuff. They deserve first class. Okay, so I would really appreciate help from the public that comes. Will now be directed towards our ministry, and we will see what help is best fitted. But all in all, we are committed, the ministry is committed, and our government is also committed to ensure that our senior citizens age with the dignity, respect that they deserve. What we have basically done this year, I was always interested in this home from the beginning, but because it came under Ministry of Health, and I think we should thank the Ministry of Health and the staff for the upkeep of these homes. No, definitely not. Throughout the year, we have made plans. And when we found, even though the homes would not have come under us, we would still would have, you know, been committed to that. So now it's making our work more easy with the Baba Singh Ashram and the Samambula Old People's Home and this Golden Age home coming under us. Actually, it's not going to be a challenge. I think it's going to be a blessing working for these homes for me. And I have good support from my staff as well. I mean, my staff have sacrificed the weekend to come painting and refurbishing the recreation, but that's not the end to it. And if I may note that we are forging a good partnership with the Reach for Your Future Foundation, where we have Ganesh based in Melbourne as its president. And they have assured us of the furniture for the refurbishment of this home. So this home is going to be our target for this year. And as we move along, we will move on to the other homes. Once we complete our programs, then of course we'll advise you. But again, the plans are for uplifting the levels of comforts for these people, the equipment that they might need, you know, because most of them you'll see that they're on wheelchairs, and so we need to ensure that the buildings are wheelchair access, and we need to ensure that the health is given priority so that we do not have amputations. And I just found out that there's side problem as well. So those are some of the things we look at, and of course we'll work with Ministry of Health. We will continue. We will have an MOU with Ministry of Health where the medical services will be provided by the Ministry of Health. So the solution we are giving here is for families to come and take them now. Why would families want to wait, you know, till a member passes away? That's my concern. Of course families will have the first right. We don't deny that. But the plea here is for them to come, take them away. I mean, look after them so that they can die in dignity as well. I mean, why the hypocrisy? Simple as that. Why the hypocrisy? If I can't look after my parents and I put them in a home, and then when they pass away, I want to come and do the final rites, aren't I a hypocrite? So we don't want that. So it's just again a simple plea to the families. Please, we know you are out there. We know you are out there, and we know that you know your relatives are here. So do the right thing.